Hello, I filmed this video the day after Tomorrow X Together's comeback, but I'm lazy so here it is 2 weeks late. Sorry not sorry.
Hey, what's up guys, Justash here. So, oh lord, I've already spilt my juice everywhere. So, Tomorrow by Together had a comeback this week. At long last. And I was so excited for it. I've finally listened to the album, watched all the performances, watched the music video, and because I don't have any real life K-pop friends, I'm gonna talk to my fake internet friends about K-pop and exactly what I think of their album The Dream Chapter Magic and their comeback in general. So if you haven't already figured out, this video is going to be about K-pop. If you don't like K-pop, don't watch this video instead of watching it and then telling me how much you hate K-pop, because I don't care. Also, if you do like K-pop or various other random stuff, maybe think about giving me a subscribe. Your girl is trying to get YouTube famous after all, and if you like K-pop, give this video a like as well. Anyway, now that the begging is done, let's move on talking about Tomorrow by Together and their comeback. First things first, I really love their album, The Dream Chapter Magic. There is not a single song on it that I genuinely dislike, which makes a change, because there's usually at least one song on an album that I really don't like. Sometimes it is the title track. Double Knot, looking at you. Sorry, Stray Kids. Anyway, I really like the fact that the album sounds a bit more unique as well. The problem I had with the Dream Chapter Star was that while the songs were good, and I love Crown, I love Blue Orangeade, they were just a bit generic sounding, like you couldn't really attribute them to any particular band. They were just very generic sounding pop songs. The Dream Chapter Magic, however, has a much more unique sound, which I'm so happy for. I love the vibe of the album. I really love the vibe of all of the songs. I think it's a step in the right direction for Tomorrow by Together. I also really like the styling on this comeback. I love the concepts that we've seen on stages already and in the music videos, and I really enjoy the fact that the members are styled to look their age rather than being styled to look a lot younger with the Dream Chapter Star and their debut. I feel like they were styled to look a lot younger than they are. I do appreciate the members are quite young. They range in age from their Magnae is 17 to, I think, 20, maybe 21 is their Magnae's age. But I'm so glad they look their age instead of looking like they're trying to look so much younger. It's one of my favorite things about this comeback is the styling. Now, obviously, I am gonna talk about each song on the album, and I am gonna have more to say about some songs than others, just because they are songs that have had performances or music videos, things like that, and some haven't. However, let me just talk about the album in general for a moment, because I had the album on repeat while I was getting ready today, and I didn't get bored, which is nice, because usually if I have the same 6 or 7 songs on repeat over and over again, I get bored really fast and I don't wanna listen to it anymore. I also, again, as I've said before, really enjoy the vibe of the album. It sounds so much more mature, not in a they sound older when they sing kind of way, just the feel of the music sounds like you can really see how much they've developed even in these few months since they debuted, because they debuted in March. I feel like it's March. I'm gonna have some like proper Tomorrow by Together stands in the comments telling me that I'm completely wrong, but I think it was March. It was definitely earlier this year, and you can really see how far they've come since then, and that's also reflected in their choreography, which I'll get to when I talk about it, because I'm going to talk about the choreographies we've seen separately when I talk about the songs. Anyway, this is getting rambly, let's move on. Okay, so I have my phone up because I don't 100% know the order of the songs yet. The first song on the album is called New Rules. This was a song that was performed by Tomorrow by Together on their Mnet Welcome Back show. I like this song. It's not necessarily my favorite song off the album, but it's not one that I'm particularly meh about either. I do like it. It's got a kind of, the like in my mind, I wanna say R&B hip hop beat from the 90s, but I don't think that's right. So please bear with me if that's a really inaccurate description. The choreography for New Rules, again, not one of my favorites. I personally feel it looks a bit messy, but you can see the level of choreography that Tomorrow by Together are attempting is definitely a step above what they were doing for Crown and Blue Orange Aid. It's not so prevalent in the performance for New Rules, mostly because I personally don't really like the choreography for it. It's not bad choreography, it's just choreography that I don't necessarily like the most. I did, however, love the costumes they wore for their Mnet stage for this. I think it looked so grown up. They really looked more unique. They didn't just look like a generic boy band. They had a real sense of presence while they were performing, which was really nice, and I'm really glad to see it for them. The second song on the album is 9 3/4 Runaway. This is the title track. It was performed on their Mnet Welcome Back show. It has a music video. It was on their TXT Time, which is like their Bangtan Bomb, which is the only comparison I'm gonna make to BTS in this video, is that their TXT Time is like the Bangtan Bombs that you get from BTS. That's the only comparison I'm gonna make. They are a completely separate band. They have a completely separate style, completely separate sound. I adore this song. It is my favorite off the album. I watched the music video for it before I listened to the album, and I immediately knew that it was gonna be one of those songs that I could listen to on repeat for hours at a time and never get bored. It is fantastic. I really love the musicality of it. I love the way it sounds. I'm not good at describing music, so you will have to bear with me with my rambling, but it's got more of a rock-ish kind of vibe than a pure pop vibe or a pure hip-hop vibe. There's a lot of stuff going on in this song, but I love it. I love the melody, I love the hook, I love the lyrics, I love the fact that it's got a Harry Potter reference in the title. I adore the choreography. This is my favorite choreography for songs that we have seen performed so far. I really think it has such a great physicality to it. It's really an improvement on their choreography that they've done in the past. Again, it doesn't necessarily look like the cleanest choreography, but with the style of choreography and the style of performance they're going for with this song, I really don't think having like neat, sharp choreography is necessarily the best. I think it looks good that sometimes their arms aren't in exactly the same position. But anyway, I'm not a dancer. I shouldn't be criticizing the choreography because I adore it. I love the music video. Do I know what's going on? No. Do I want to get into theories? Yes, but not right now. If you have any theories, please leave them in the comments though, because I would love to watch them. I think the styling for the video is fantastic. There's just enough choreography in it, but it also tells a story. I love the song. It's my favorite song. It's a very deserving title track. Yes, fantastic. Next up, we have Roller Coaster, which has a kind of funky video game soundtrack kind of vibe, at least at the very beginning. It's the thing that I remember the most about it. Unfortunately, with Roller Coaster, while I don't dislike it, it's just a bit bleh, for me at least, especially considering how it comes after 9 3/4 on the album. So it is the one that I tend to pay the least attention to because I'm still really hyped after 9 3/4. So it's a good song. It sounds really cool. It's got a good vibe to it, but for me, it's a bit bleh. After that is a song called Poppin' Star. I like this song. It's got a kind of cutesy vibe to it, I believe, if it's the one that I think it is. Like I said, I listened to this album on repeat while I was getting ready, so all of the songs didn't necessarily blend into one, but I just kind of forgot the order of them, so you'll have to bear with me if some of them are wrong. I will double check when I edit this, and if I'm wrong, I will say so. But anyway, Poppin' Star has a really like cutesy kind of vibe to it. I really like it. It's a good contrast to the rest of the album. I think it's the one on the album that's probably the most similar to the title track Crown from the Dream Chapter Star, but it's still a step up from that. You can still see the development in it, which is really nice. I want to see choreography for it or a music video. I think it's a sort of song that would really suit that. I appreciate that they have 3 choreographies, 1 music video, and 1 pre-recorded performance that they've already put out for this comeback. So maybe in a few months, we'll get a Poppin' Star video as well. Then we have the song, Can't We Just Leave the Monster Alive? Now, I love this song. It's possibly my second favorite song from the Dream Chapter Magic. Why? Well, you'll have to bear with me, because the reason why I like this song so much is it gives me a really specific sense of nostalgia. I don't know why, it just does. Basically, it takes me back to like the summer of 2013, where I'd just left college, I wasn't going to university, I was just having a good time, it was really nice, and this song takes me back there. Now, I know that that is a really specific vibe to get from a song. I get the same vibe from a couple of other songs. 80s's Wave gives me the same vibe for whatever reason, and that's why I really like this song. I appreciate that not everyone else, or anyone else really, will get that same vibe because it's a very specific to me kind of thing, but I think it's a good summer song. It's definitely one that I'd like to see performed live, with choreography or without. It does kind of feel a bit like a stand around the stage and sing song. Not that that's a bad thing at all, it just means there's a higher focus on vocal performance, which is fine. I'd love to see all five members stand on stage and just sing this song. I think it would be really cool. Next up, we have Magic Island, and this is kind of a ballad song, but kind of not. Basically, it's the slow song on the album. I like it, but I'm not the biggest fan of slow songs. If you check the album review I did for Map of Your Soul Persona, I pretty much sum it up when I'm talking about Jamais Vu, why I don't like slow songs. So this isn't a favorite of mine. Again, it sounds like another stand around the stage and sing song, but if it was on a playlist, while I wouldn't necessarily start the playlist with Magic Island, I certainly wouldn't skip it. Next, we have 20 Centimeters, and this is the song that was a pre-recorded performance on the Welcome Back show. I believe that's what they're called. It was a bit like a music video, but they were still singing. I enjoyed it. It's a really nice, kind of slow-ish song. There's a lot of emotion in it though. I'm not very good at pinpointing emotions or like what emotions I'm feeling or what a song makes me feel, but it feels like a very emotional song. I do enjoy it, not one of my favorites off the album. And finally, we have Angel or Devil. This is another song that I really enjoy. I love the choreography for it. Even if it's not as physical as, say, 9¾ or some of their older choreography like Crown and Blue Orangeade, I really like the choreography for Angel or Devil. I enjoy the fact that you can see the push and pull of both sides in it. The song itself is really good. I enjoy it a lot. It's one of the ones that I will hit repeat on and listen to over and over again. Just that one song rather than the whole album. And I also really enjoy the way the vocals sound. There's one part in like the second half of the song where Subin sings Black or White, Pick a Color, and I'm just like, mwah, perfect. Absolutely perfect vocals from that song. Those are my thoughts on the album. I really don't have anything else to say that isn't just gonna be me fangirling in a respectful way for the next hour and a half. So I'm gonna wrap it up here before this video gets too much. I'm still not very good at ending my YouTube videos, so if you have enjoyed the Dream Chapter Magic, please leave me a comment down below with your favorite song. Maybe give this video a like, because your girl's trying to get YouTube famous, and if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I will see you next week for more content.